In this video, I wanted to discuss about 8086 assembly language programming simulation by using one of the simulator, that is EMU8086. I will explain here some of the programs, then how to write and how to execute in this emulator software. Simple programs first we will discuss here. The first one is move AL comma 99H, then increment AL. This program simply increments an 8-bit data. Here the 99 is the value that will be incremented by 1. After 99, what is the next number? That is 9A. We'll simulate, then what happens we'll discuss now. First here click emulate, then if you observe here, this is the program move AL comma 099H increment AL, then run this code. Then if you observe here the value is 9A. That means the value of 99 is incremented by 1. If you write the same program for the decrement, this program decrements an 8-bit value, that is 99. If you decrement 99 by 1, that is the value is 98. Now we'll discuss here. Now if you observe here in the AX, the value of AX here, the value is 98. That means the contents of AL is decremented by 1. Similarly, if you wanted to increment or decrement by 16-bit data, the same data I am taking here for the 16-bit here. Then this program increments the 16-bit data by 1, INCAX, that is 999. The result is, after this program is executed, the contents of AX is 999A. We'll see the result. If you observe here, the AX here, 999A. Therefore, the contents of AX is incremented by 1. If you observe here the same program for the decrement of 16-bit data, you observe here the data is decremented by 1, 9, 9, 9, 8. Next we will discuss here ones complement of the data, how to find the ones complement of 8-bit data. For example, 10101010 binary. I have given here the binary data. 10101010 I have given. Then not AL. Then this program, after this program is executed, the contents of AL must be 010101010. We will check here. That is 1's complement. If you observe here the binary 010101010. Actually, we have given the data 10101010. Now the value is converted into 010101010. That is the ones complement program for the 8-bit data. Similarly, we can convert into 16-bit data. Then if you wanted to find 2's complement, simply add here one more instruction, that is called increment AL. After finding 1's complement, if we add 1, then that will be 2's complement of an 8-bit data. If you emulate again, now here, if you observe here, this is the 2's complement value 0101110. This is the 2's complement of 10101010. Then coming to the next program, simple addition of 2 numbers. Let us consider 2 numbers. Move AL, 88H. Move BL, 33H. Then add AL, BL. This program, the first year the 88 is transferred to AL, next year 33 is transferred to BL, next the contents of AL and the contents of BL are added, the result is transferred to AL, then halt. Then we will check how the result. If you observe here, BB is the answer. Finally, the answer is available in hexadecimal. Why? Because 8383 will be added. 8 plus 3 means that is 11 in hexadecimal. The 11 is B. Similarly, 8311, that is 11, that is value is B in 8086. Therefore, the value is BB. Coming to the next one, if you go for the 16-bit addition, the same program to be modified for the 16-bit addition also. If you press again emulate here, then some error is there, that the, for example here, this is the value BX. Why? Because we cannot transfer 16-bit data into 8-bit, that's why I have got an error. Now here there is no errors, then run this program. Now if you observe here, $BCR, B, 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 higher order is BB, as well as the lower order is also BB. That is the result for addition of 2 16-bit numbers. Now here, if the numbers are minimum, there is no problem. If the numbers are more than F, 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 the maximum value here is FFF, then more than FF, there is a carry will be generated. Then if you add 2 16-bit numbers, the maximum is 17 bits. Therefore, how to store that 17 bit? I wanted to store that 17 bit in a DXS. For example, the numbers are more here, 9, 9, 9, 9. Actually, the answer is 1, 2, 2, 2, 1. Therefore, how to store that 1? We will discuss in this program. I am taking here one more register, that is move DX, 00. Then add AX, BX. Jump if no carry. I am writing OK here. Then point OK, that is halt. That means if the carry is not generated, halt. Otherwise, increment DX, then halt. Here this program will works for the any carry generated. If carry is generated, increment DX instruction will be executed. If carry is not generated, this instruction will be skipped. Directly the program will be halt. I will explain with 2 examples. First we will take without carry, then we will go for the with carry. Let us consider these two numbers. Use emulate here, then run the program. We'll check here the AX and DX registers. AX register is AAA, then if you wanted to consider, the DX register is 000. Why? Because here there is no quick carry generated if you add these two numbers. Now if you change the numbers here, I've changed the numbers is 9999, then we'll see the difference. I will execute here the single step. Here add BX, add DX, then add AX comma BX. Jump if no carry, it will go to all. Otherwise this will be executed, then all. Previously that instruction, that is ANC DX, will be skipped now. Now the program is halted. Then we will see the result. Now the AX value is 2221, the extra digit that is stored in DX. Now the DX value is 0001. That means the carry is stored here. This is the carry. In this way, we can store the result of the 16-bit data. Next, we'll discuss here whether which number is greater, whether the first number is greater or the second number is greater. Then how to check here. Then here I will tell how to find which number is greater. You know already one of the instruction, that is compare. Instead of add AX comma BX here, compare AX comma BX. Compare AX comma BX. Now here, whenever the compare AX comma BX, flags will be affected. There are three possibilities are there. The first possibility is, if AX is equal to BX, both are equal, zero flag will be affected. If AX is greater than BX, carry flag will not be affected. If AX is less than BX, carry flag will be affected. Based on this, we can decide which number is greater. I have written here, jump if no carry, okay. Now here, finally I wanted to store the result in the AX. For example, if the carry is not generated, that means AX is greater than BX. If carry is generated, BX is greater than AX. For that, what I am using here is move AX comma BX. That means finally the largest number is stored in AX register. Here first number is transferred to AX, the second number is transferred to BX. Now the compare instruction is executed here. Compare AX comma BX, jump if no carry, okay, then halt. Carry is not generated means the contents of AX is greater than BX. If the carry is generated, the contents of BX are greater than AX, therefore the BX value is transferred to AX. Finally, the largest number is stored in AX. We will check here. Again, press emulate here, then run. See here. Finally, the largest value is stored in AX. What is there in AX? Actually, we have taken 88A, we have taken in AX. But finally, here the result is 999. That is, the largest number is stored in AX. Similarly, if you wanted to store smallest number in AX, simply you modify here jump if carry. Jump if carry halt, otherwise jump if no carry BX comma AX. That means carry generated means the first number is smaller than the second number. Otherwise the second number is smaller than the first number if carry is not generated. if carry is generated, the second number is greater than the first number. Therefore, directly write halt. The why? Because the contents of AX is smaller than the BX. Now we'll check here. Now here, the contents of AX is equal to 8888. That means the smallest number is 8888. If you are having any doubt, we'll change the numbers here. Now I am changing the second number into 6666. Then we'll see the difference. What is the smallest number here? 666. You observe here, the contents of AX is 6666. That means the finally the result is stored in AX, that is the smallest number is stored in AX. That is about the smallest and largest numbers in 8086. Next we will discuss about the general syntax of the programming. Here how to write the data segment, then how to write the code segment, then how to assign the variables, we will discuss in this example. I have considered two numbers, num1db 33h, num2db 44h, then result I have declared initially 00h. I wanted to store the result of the addition of these two numbers in the result variable. Then I wanted to end the data segment, therefore data ends. Then assume CS code DS data. By using this, we wanted to tell I am using code segment as my code segment, data segment is my data segment. Then actual code segment starts here. Then coming to the first instruction here, start move AX comma data move DS comma AX. Why? Because if you wanted to fetch the data from our data segment, therefore that data segment address must be available in data segment register, that is DS. For that we have written this one. Why? Because we cannot directly move the data to DS, therefore first transfer to AX, then AX to DS. Then move AL comma num1, num1, what is the num1? 33 we have assigned. The num1 is transferred to AL, add AL comma num2. AL is the value 33, num2 is 44, that is 7. The result is stored at AL. Then move result comma AL. Why? Because here initially I have assigned the result with 00. Now that result is 77 is transferred to AL, then ALT. Then we will see how to execute this program. If you observe here, move AL comma, move AX comma data. Now here 00710H is the our data segment address, that is transferred to DS. And how to run this program? For seeing the result, go for the vars here. If you observe here, this is the result 77H. If you observe here, the three variables here, the first one is num1, that is 33h, num2 44h, then the result is 77h. Our result will be 77h. Next we will discuss about finding a largest number in an array. Before going to discuss finding a largest number in an array, you must know how to define an array. First here, num1 is the array name, db is the array type defined by, then the elements are separated by comma. I have taken 5 elements here, 33h, 44h, 55h, 22h, 11h. This is the array declaration. Array name, that is user defined. I have used here num1, you can use anyone. Then db, that is the type. If I have written db here, you must write all our elements are in byte. If you have used dw here, you can use the words here. Now I wanted to store the result. That is the smallest number, largest number in the result. Therefore, I have declared a variable db with 00. Then coming to the program here, move ax comma data again, move ds comma ax, then lea si comma num1, that is the effective address of the num1 is transferred to si. This instruction must be required whenever you are using array of data. Then move cx comma 04h, that is the count register. Move al comma si, the first element is transferred to al, then compare al comma si plus 1, the second element is compared here. If both are compared, if the first one is greater than the second one, then jump if no carry, carry will not be generated, it will go to ok, increment si, again it compare with next one, like that it will be, this program will be executed. Finally, the smallest number is stored in the result here. This loop will be executed 4 times, then finally it is coming out al. Whenever the second one is greater than first one, then move al comma si plus 1 instruction will be executed, otherwise it will not be executed. Then we will check how the program will works. Go to variables here, then I will show the num1. I have taken the 5 elements, therefore here all the 5 elements 33, 44, 55, 22, 11 I have given. I have find the largest number among these, therefore the result is 55H. The result is 55H. We have got the result is 55H. Actually, this is the array we have taken. This is the array we have taken. This is the array 33, 44, 55, 22, 11H we have taken. In this, we have got the result, that is the largest number is 55. Next, coming to the smallest number, this is the program. In this program I have made one change here, that is jnc. In case of jnc, I have replaced the jc, jump if carry, okay, the remaining all are same. Now if you go to variables here, now these are the taken number 33, 44, 55, 22, 11H. Then in this the smallest number is 11. Therefore the result shows 11H. In this way we can find either smallest number or the largest number. In the next program we'll discuss about the strings. Before going to discuss the string operations, you must know how to represent a string. Str1 is the string name, db the string type, then the string with single quotes. This is the string. BVC EC is the string in my example. Then result db. Actually here I am finding how many C character C's are there in this string. That is the program I am compiling here. Then I have declared a result variable again here with 00. After the program is executed, this value must be 2. Why? Because there are 2 C's there in this BVC EC. For that, this is the code I have written. Move ax comma data, move ds comma ax is common for this. Then lesa comma str1. Previously I have taken num1, that is the array of the numbers. Now the string name str1. The str1 is user defined. You may use any. I have used here str1. Move cx, 05, that is the count. Why? Because this is the length of the string. BBCC, there are 5 characters are there, therefore the length is 5. Move bx, 00, this is the counter for counting how many C's are there in that BBCC string. Move al, si, the first letter of the string is transferred to al. Compare al, c. Why? Because I wanted to check how many C's are there. Therefore, the first character is compared with C. Then, if equal, BL will be incremented. If not equal, it go for the next character. Therefore, for that, what I am using here is increment SI. The second character will be taken. Then loop OK1, it will go to here. Move AL, SI. In this case, the second character will come to AL. Again, the second character is compared. Then, if equal, BL will be incremented. If not equal, it go for the next character. Like that, this loop will be executed finally. Or finally, the result, that is BL, is the counter I am using, how many C's are there in this example. That value is transferred to result. Now, we will check how this program will be executed. Then run this program. Then go to vars here, not byte. Okay. Here B V C E C, here B V C E C is the string I have taken. Then how many times C are there? That is 02. It's 02 times. 2 times that C is presented in the given string. In this manner, we can operate the strings of 80, 86 programming.